Hey guys, welcome back to the very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and in this video we'll be creating out this brochure cover design, which is very unique. You can put your brochure inside this cover and it's going to look amazing. So let's begin the tutorial. Let's create a new document and let's name it cover, C-O-V-E-R, cover. Now let's put the unit to inches and let's give the width 11 inches and by height 8 inches, but here we'll give 16 inches because we are creating both front and back. And after that, let's add the bleeding to 0.5 inches and click OK. So now our file is created with a bleeding of 5 inches. The reason for creating this is you got extra space while you print out and you can edit that stuff. And you'll not lose the information inside the main document. So let's begin. So Control R to bring out the ruler and let's divide it by 8 by 8 inches. So here we go, half by 8 by 8, that's all. Now let's create a rectangle here and create out a rectangle. Let's give it some different color like that and lock it up, Control 2. Now let's work out with our text. So T for text, type out our text, C-R-E-A-T, have a creative lab, L-A-B lab, and let's scale this up and let's change the color to this different like orange, and let's make it fresh orange. So select it, go there, let's do the adjustments and okay. Now after that, let's change the font. So let's check out the perfect font this, and I think this is good. This is good. Next, allow bold and let's scale this down a little bit like that. Now duplicate this one more with the shift and alt pressed and let's scale it down to this much. Now with the text, select this, Control all, switch off the caps lock so that we can write it in the small fonts, and let's B-R-O-C-H-U-R-E, brochure cover, C-O-V-E-R cover. In the same way, let's duplicate this twice more. So .com, that's fine. Now let's play around with the fonts. So let's select all these three. So let's balance the gapping between the text. So let's slide it down this one like that. And let's select all these three. Let's choose the perfect font for this. So let's look around and you'll definitely find a perfect color. It's your choice. So just look around and find a nice font for this. It should look good. It should look catchy as well, and it should be visible nicely. So let's choose some nice font here. Let's zoom it out and let's see. Okay, I think this one is great for me, and let's work off with our design. So I'll just scale this up a little bit more, and this one I'll just balance this up. So let's just go here with a shift pressed, just bring it down here and so that it's got balanced, and this one I'll just push it down a little bit like that. And if you gotta see that, it's looking great. So next thing, let's create out our design. So to do that, I'll use the line segment tool and let's fill this up with the black color so that we can see the line segments, and let's create out this stuff. So from here, let's draw. So click, drag, draw from here. So let's draw out some design, Control Z. It's all about drawing out, so just continue drawing shapes. Now let's give some details. So let's do that stuff. So let's add a few here, like from there. So it's all about giving stuff, then there. And you can see we have given that gap. So we have to make sure everything is attached. So later on, we have to edit that stuff. Thank you. creating something neat. So overall, if you look at how we have created some lots of shapes here. So next thing, let's create one more rectangle on the top of that, like this. And okay, that's great. It's outlined, so it's great. Let's do some adjustments. Let's look at where we have left out the gaps. So select that and just make sure they are attached. Just zoom it in, work it out, and see all those spaces where you have done all those mistakes. And if you are okay, then after that, let's select these sticks, lock it, Control-2. Now select everything, delete the this grid for a while, select everything, and go to Pathfinder and divide it. So after dividing it, every pieces will be of different shapes. So every piece is separate and you can fill it up with different colors. So for now, let's fill this up with some color so that you can see that. So you will find out it's done. Now let's bring in our color palette. So I have drawn some color palette here, so we can use that. Open that up. And here's the color palette. I'll just bring this in. Just drag and bring this in. And let's fill this up with the colors. So first of all, this, let's make it white. Like that. So we can just give little, very light white, like that. And Control-2, or maybe let's unlock all these stuff, Control-2, and this, Control-2, lock it, rest. I just delete the background and delete it. This one, bring it to front like that. Next, we can see here we got a problem, so we can sort it out. So let's check where we have given that. So Control-2, unlock, and after that, let's see the problem. So here we go. Let's see. Selected. Okay, here we got the gap. So let's cross it up. Selecting that, divide it, and it's done. So this one, let's fill this up with the color, and you can do that. In the same way, let's check it on every L pieces. Yeah, everything is fine now. Now let's do the coloring stuff. Okay, first of all, ungroup all. Ungroup, and everything is separate. I'll just delete this out. And this one, Control-2, this one, Control-2. Now I select all these pieces, and with the eye picker, select this color. The same way, from here top few pieces selected, and with the eye picker, select the same color. Select few more pieces from downside, and from here also. Next thing, let's remove the outline strokes from here. So Control-2 and select these two pieces, remove the stroke color like that. We need to remove the background image because we have to export it out in PNG so that we got this empty space. Next, here let's create a division. So I'll just use the line segment and draw the line segment here. And let's give some stroke color black and go to stroke, and I'll just give some dashes like that so that you can identify where to fold like that. So you can see, here we go, here's the dashes line. We can just reduce the font thickness, that's line segment thickness, to around 0.25 like that. And next, on the background, let's type out some text. So I'll use this same stuff here. I'll just drag and drag, and see. Okay, that's great. And here, let's give a rectangle here like that. And with the apico, select the color and arrange it to back. So here we go. Let's keep it clean. And this way, we have created this basic design. And let's export this out, and we'll create a template in a Photoshop which will be editable, and you can change the any font, any color text here, any design, and you can directly use the Photoshop template to do the adjustments. So after this, let's create out the template. So first of all, I'll just export this out. So save as PDF. Let's create this to PDF, and let's make it cover. Okay, then under marks and bleed, click on marks and bleed, maybe trim marks. We need trim marks, and that's all. That's all. Let's save the PDF. So here are the exported image. So next thing, to create out a template, let's create out some perspective view. So I'll go to create a new document and just create a 3D perspective rectangle like this. Let's fill this up with white color. Now what I'll do is I'll use the 3D effect, 3D extrude bevel, preview it. Let's turn it up like this and increase the perspective and decrease the stroke, this extrude depth, like that, giving it like a sheet of thin paper. And let's play around with this, like rotation, this. Let's decide a view, which perspective view you want to create for the template. So this is the place where you can play around with the perspective view. This one, let's make it rounded corner like that. See, it's looking nice effect, giving out nice effect. Play around with the perspective view and just move around with these angles and you'll get that. And after that, click OK. Once you get that, let's do some adjustments. So I'll just decrease this artboard size and like this. And what we can do next is just export this out in the form of PNG. So let's save for web and go to PNG. You can see this is transparent. You can increase the size here. Let's give it 1000. Place where you want to save your file. So just go around. Let's say you want to save it in the desktop. Just save it. Name it perspective and just save it. Save. So now let's go to Photoshop and create out the template for this design. In the next video, we'll be working on Photoshop and create out the whole brochure cover template, which will be 100% editable. You can just replace the file with your own design and the template is ready. So don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.